next event here on World Championship Wrestling, introducing from Delray Beach, California, at 210 pounds, Sean Regal. And his partner from Salisbury, North Carolina, 235 pounds, it's Gene Ligon. And introducing their opponents, making their way into the ring area.
Team in professional wrestling. They rank right up there with arthritis and polio as one of the three great cripplers. Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
You know, I don't think he would even be welcome in the Vatican with Noriega. No. I don't think Cornette would, even the Pope would not even give him sanctuary. He would drive the Pope crazy.
You know, I heard the Pope and him on speaking terms of the best friends, Jim.
That was Bobby Pope.
Oh, Bobby Pope. You know something, Jim? You can talk about tag teams. We have a lot of great ones in the NWA. But right here, Bobby Eaton and Stan Lane are probably the longest running tag team we have in the NWA.
They certainly are. That means they know each other's moves before the other does it, practically. And I want to tell you something. I have my problems with Cornette's philosophy at times, but he is a great strategist. He is a great motivator, and he has been one of the most successful managers in the history of the sport. Now, don't tell him I said that because he won't believe you. He's making his way over here, and he will be hearing his comments whether we want to or not. Again, fans, I won't probably get the chance to say anything else. Main event tomorrow night, 6:05, Rock and Roll Express and the Freebirds. Matter of fact, I'm going to ask James E. James, my friend, welcome to our area.
Wait a minute. First of all, now, let's not get so overly familiar,
I was talking Jim. I was talking to the gardener behind you, James yeah, Brown. Yeah. He's on the levee from...
James Brown, last time he said, ow, he wasn't singing.
Hey, I want to tell you something. I got to ask you a question.
Well, please do, because I'm trying to enlighten you.
All right. Tomorrow, on the main event, the Rock and Roll Express meet the Freebirds. You guys have wrestled both many times, especially the Rock and Roll Express. Would you please give us a prediction?
I predict that the Rock and Roll Express is going to be the shortest live return. This Express is going to be an Express, all right? Shorter it's going to be an Express out of town.
Shorter than Roberto Duran?
Shorter than Roberto Duran, and they don't even speak Spanish. At least I don't think Morton does. I don't know what language Gibson speaks, but the fact is, if the Freebirds don't finish him off, then we're going to. Because I've said it once, I've said it a million times, the day the music died was the last time that the Rock and Roll Express got in the ring with the Midnight Express.
Gene Ligon in there against Beautiful Bobby, a little bit, a little troubled. Is Bobby in a good mood tonight, Corny?
Bobby's not happy because, you know, we got these dynamic dudes are still on our trail, still trying to cry and beg and plead to the promoters, as Kevin Sullivan knows they do so well, trying to get an advantage in the contracts. Plus, we got the Rock and Roll Express back in the NWA. It's enough to drive a man to drink. Matter of fact, I've already had 5 Pepsis tonight.
He is hyper.
I didn't mean to interrupt you. I was talking about how great the Midnight Express are as a team. They have been together longer than any team in the NBA. Beautiful Bobby is, to me, one of the underrated wrestlers of all time. I just want to ask you one thing. When you were out there in the Louisville Slugger and you had the champ out there, what was woman trying to do, interfering? What was her main purpose, Jim, you know?
I don't know. I was trying to talk to Flair. I think he pulled some strings to get Sting a title shot instead of a guy like Luger. He wants to wrestle his friend. Sure, Flair does. But then woman comes out here. Woman has been, I understand, shadowing Ric Flair, following his movements around. She's got something to gain by owning the Horsemen, obviously, the most elite group in wrestling. I think that's what is on woman's mind.
Well, right now, Jimbo, your guys are having a tough time here.
No. What we're doing is we're lulling. It's an old trick of the Midnight Express. Lulling our opponents into a sense of false security. That's exactly what we're doing. That's how we beat the punks like the Dynamic Dudes, because they're not smart enough to deal with strategy like that. That's how we got rid of the Rock and Roll Express, regardless of what that little peacock Ricky Morton says. It was a long, bitter, and bloody feud. But after 5 years, the Midnight Express prevailed, and the Rock and Roll Express left the NWA. Now they've come back. They didn't learn the lesson well enough. We'll be glad to open up our college of wrestling knowledge again.
Sean Regal there being punished by beautiful Bobby, a little unorthodox, got his neck draped over that cable there.
Oh, Kevin, you like that, don't you?
I find that humorous? I find it very humorous. Jimmy, I saw you back there talking to Cactus Jack Manson. Were you conversing on books or what was it?
You know something? Cactus Jack Manson is my kind of guy. A little hard to follow a conversation with
him. I'd agree with that.
But he's my, well, please do that. But he's my kind of guy because Cactus Jack is a great professional wrestler. He's up and coming. Maybe he needs a little guidance. You never know. Look at this, the Midnight Express. Another one of their beautiful teamwork maneuvers. They got Sean Regal now. He don't know which way he's going.
Karate kick right in the face.
Good boy, he don't know whether to get up, fall down, or what. Now look, beautiful Bobby's coming at him, baby. He's waiting for his opening. Yes!
Well, what a move. It's illegal because it's outside the ring, but it's still nonetheless effective.
I don't care if it's illegal, I don't care if it's immoral, and I don't care if it's not. Nobody does it better than Bobby. When he wants to hurt somebody, he hurts them.
And also, let's make the point, it was done within the 10 count, Jim, so it was legal.
Courtney, I
maybe not ethical.
It wasn't ethical.
Legal.
This Friday night on our Power Hour, Arn Anderson and Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer, Kevin Sutherland said it will be the most physical match ever on the Power Hour.
I don't think we're talking physical here. I think we're talking brutal. I think we're talking, these guys are going to go after windpipes, goozle pipes, anything else. Speaking of which, right there is Sean Regal. He's going to be taken through a straw and eating melted ice cream for a couple of weeks. You see, Arn Anderson and Buzz Sawyer, they're both the kind of pit bull type of wrestler. Much like yourself, Kevin, they're going to go after their opponent and do anything they can to him. That's why I'm looking forward to the match.
Beautiful Bobby was tagged in and got him with a great clothesline there. Sean Regal is really in dire straits. It's just a matter of time, perhaps, for Sean Regal to fold his tent because the Midnight Express have had about a 5-to-1 tag ratio advantage here. Gene Liggins started out, and he's pretty much disappeared.
Jimmy Cornette, I need to ask you a question. You being a mastermind, is Lex Luger going to try to do something to stop? What a beautiful move.
Great team move there, it is.
Another move that we invented and perfected. We're the innovators in tag team wrestling.
What I was asking you is, will Lex Luger do something before February 25th to stop Sting having a title match with Ric Flair?
Oh, he's going to try. There's no doubt about it, because Lex Luger feels like he should have had that shot, and probably he should have. He's going to do anything in the book to try to make sure that he is in line for it if something happens to Sting. And right there, that's what's going to happen to the Dudes and the Rock and Roll Express and any other team in our way.
The winners of the event, the Midnight Express.
Well, I kind of feel like I've been rested here with Jim Cornette, and maybe we'll get a few more words in right after we come back here, ladies and gentlemen, on World Championship Wrestling.
Ladies and